Today, I'll be presenting before you my lecture on the topic Phenols, their preparation and properties. Phenols are analogous to alcohol. Phenols have the functional group OH. These are the compounds with an OH group which is attached to an aromatic carbon. These share same functional group with the alcohols, where the OH group is attached to the aliphatic carbon. The chemistry of phenol is very different from that of the alcohol, because in case of alcohol, the OH group is attached to the aliphatic carbon, whereas in case of phenols, the OH group is attached to the aromatic carbon. Now, coming on to the classification of the phenols. Phenols can be classified as monohydric, dihydric, or trihydric. This classification is similar to that of the alcohols. Monohydric phenols are the phenols, or we can say the other aromatic compounds in which only one OH group is present, like the simple phenol or cresol. Cresol are the compounds where OH group is present along with the CH3 group. These can be orthocresol, metacresol or paracresol, depending on the position of the OH and the CH3 group. In the next classification is the dihydric phenol. Dihydric phenols are the compounds which has two OH groups, like catechol or orthohydroxybenzene, or quinol, which is known as para-hydroxybenzene, and resorcinol, which is known as meta-hydroxybenzene. In the case of trihydric alcohols, as the name indicates, tri, which means three. Three OH groups are attached to the aromatic benzene ring. These can be 1,2,3 trihydroxybenzene or 1,2,4 trihydroxybenzene, or these can be 1,3,5 trihydroxybenzene. After the classification, we discuss the nomenclature of the phenols. Phenols are usually named as the substituted phenols. The methyl phenols are given the special name, which are known as cresols. Some other phenols are named as hydroxy compounds. Here are few examples which I have discussed. The first one is the 3-butyl phenol. If we look at this compound, at the third position from the functional group, which is OH, first carbon, second carbon, third carbon. On the third carbon, we have butyl group. Therefore, the name of this compound is 3-butyl phenol. The second compound, where we have a amino group on the second position to the functional OH group, this is known as 2-aminophenol. The third case, we have nitro group at the fourth position from the functional group. This is the first carbon to which OH is attached, then comes the second carbon, third carbon, and on the fourth carbon, the nitro group is attached. Therefore, it is named as 4-nitrophenol. Coming on to the physical properties of phenols. The first one is the state and smell. These are colorless crystalline, and these can be solids or liquids, depending on their molecular weights. Next is the solubility. Phenols are sparingly soluble in water. These form weak hydrogen bonding with water because in this case the size of the phenyl group is very large as compared to the aliphatic alcohols. And this large size, it masks the polar character of the OH group, due to which these are only sparingly soluble in water. But these are soluble in the organic solvents like ethers, alcohols, and many other organic solvents like chloroform, acetone, etc. Coming on to the boiling point of phenols. These boil at higher temperature than aromatic hydrocarbons of the comparable molecular mass. As in case of this example, this is toluene, whereas this is phenol. If we look at the molecular weight of toluene and phenol, these have comparable molecular weight. Molecular weight of toluene is 92, whereas that of the alcohol, this phenol, is 94. But there is a large difference in their boiling point. Toluene boils at 384 Kelvin, whereas phenol boils at 455 Kelvin. And the difference in the boiling point of these two compounds is due to the presence of hydrogen bonding. Though there is less hydrogen bonding in phenols as compared to alcohols, but still there is some hydrogen bonding, and due to which the boiling point is more than the corresponding aromatic hydrocarbons. Intramolecular hydrogen bonding is possible in some ortho-substituted phenols. This intramolecular hydrogen bonding reduces the water solubility and increases the volatility of the compound. Thus, ortho-nitrophenol is steam distillable, while the isomer of this compound, para-nitrophenol, is not. What is intramolecular hydrogen bonding? There is difference between intramolecular and intermolecular hydrogen bonding. Intermolecular hydrogen bonding takes place between two different molecules, like a phenol is hydrogen bonded to another phenol or a water molecule. This is called intermolecular hydrogen bonding. Whereas intramolecular hydrogen bonding takes place in the same molecule, like in case of orthonitrophenol. If we look at this molecule, we can see that the OH group and the nitro group, these are present ortho to each other. Since the ortho position is the closest position among all other positions, so the hydrogen of the OH group and the OH and the oxygen of the nitro group, these can hydrogen bond to each other. If we look at other isomer, that is the para-nitrophenol, or we can take even the meta-nitrophenol, the nitro group and the OH group are far apart, and therefore these groups cannot hydrogen bond to each other. So intramolecular hydrogen bonding is present only in the ortho compounds and not in the meta or para compounds. Next topic is the methods of preparation of phenols. I will be discussing the various methods by which the phenols can be prepared. The first method is from the diazonium salt. This is a diazonium salt, and the hydrolysis of this diazonium salt in the presence of dilute acid, which we can take HCl or sulfuric acid, this results in phenol. Next method is by the fusion of alkali fusion of sulfonates. If this is a sulfonate compound, when it is fused with any alkali, it can be sodium hydroxide or potassium hydroxide at high temperature, 300 degrees Celsius, this will result in sodium phenoxide. It is a sodium salt, which on further hydrolysis results in phenol. Next method is from cumene hydroperoxide. This compound is called cumene hydroperoxide. This compound on hydrolysis in presence of any dilute acid like HCl or sulfuric acid, this results in the phenol and the side product acetone. The next method is from aryl halides. We can take any aryl halide. Like in this case, I have taken nitrochlorobenzene. This aryl halide on reaction with a base like NaOH, this results in the sodium salt of the halide which we have taken. And this sodium salt of the halide on reaction with any dilute acid, that is on hydrolysis, it results in phenol. In this case, we obtained para-nitrophenol because this was a substituted aryl halide, where on para position a nitro group was present. The next method is from the Grignard reagent. Phenols can also be prepared from Grignard reagents by treating aryl magnesium halide with oxygen followed by hydrolysis. This is the Grignard reagent RMGX, that is an organometallic compound to which a halide group is present. We react this Grignard reagent with oxygen. This oxygen is introduced between the aromatic ring and the magnesium bromide, which on further hydrolysis results in the phenol, our required compound. Next is the method from phenolic acids. This is the phenolic acid. We have taken sodium salicylate. This on distillation with sodium with the soda lime results in phenol. Soda lime is a mixture of NaOH and CaO. When this sodium salicylate reacts with NaOH in presence of calcium oxide, we obtain phenol and sodium carbonate as the side product. Now coming on to the chemical reactions of phenols. Phenols have aryl ring as well as a OH group. And the reactions of phenols are due to both the things, due to OH ring, due to benzene ring, and due to the OH group. First, we will be discussing the reactions due to the phenolic group. First one is the acidic nature. Phenols are more acidic than alcohols. This will be discussing how these are more acidic than alcohol. Their acidic nature can be checked by the various reactions. The first one is, if we take a litmus paper, a blue litmus paper, and dip it in a phenol solution, it will turn the blue litmus paper into red. This shows its acidic nature. Next is with active metal. Phenols on reaction with any alkali metal like sodium, lithium, potassium, etc., it liberates hydrogen. That is the hydrogen of the OH group. This hydrogen is replaced by the sodium, and this hydrogen is liberated as hydrogen gas, which shows its acidic nature. This means the hydrogen present to the OH group, this hydrogen is acidic in nature. Next reaction is with base. We know an acid reacts with base to give a salt and water. Similarly, this group, phenol, it reacts with a base, NaOH, which is a base, to give salt and water. If we compare the acid strength of various hydrocarbons, we find the order of the compounds as shown here. Alkanes are least acidic, then comes ammonia, then comes alkynes, then alkenes, then alcohols, then waters, and after water is phenol. Phenol is more acidic than water, and more acidic to phenol are carbonic acids, then come carboxylic acid, and the most acid among the organic compounds are the hydrogen fluorides. Here we will be discussing the resonance of phenoxide ion. This is alcohol, and this is the alcohol, and this is the phenol. If we react alcohol with water, we obtain hydronium ion and RO negative group. And if we react phenol with water, we obtain hydronium ion and the alkoxide group. This is called phenoxide. When with alcohol, it is called alkoxide. Now we'll look on to the resonance structure of the phenoxide ion. This is the phenoxide ion. This keeps on resonating. Oxygen already has two lone pair of electrons. And when a proton get out from here, it leaves its electron. So this negative charge is left on the oxygen. Now these lone pair of oxygen, these participate in the resonance with the ring. We can see this lends it one of the lone pair to the ring, and the double bond, these further changes their position. These keep on changing their position. In the next structure, we find that the negative charge on the ring, it forms a bond at this position, and the bond which was present between these two carbon, it shifts to another position to form a negative charge. The valency of the carbon has to be kept four. So accordingly, the bonds are moved. This negative charge, it again moves on to the next position and forms a bond. And the bond which was present here, it moves to the carbon to form a negative charge. And this keeps on resonating. These are called the resonating structures of phenoxide ion. And due to these resonating structures, phenol are more acidic than alcohol. And the reason is that the phenoxide ion is stabilized by these resonating structures, whereas there is no such resonance present in alcohols. That is why alcohols are less acidic than the phenols. Then we can see one more thing, that the electron density increases at ortho and para position. So we can say ortho and para position are rich in electron density as compared to the meta position. Next is the effect of substituent groups on the acid strength. What type of substituent is present on the benzene along with the OH group? It makes phenol stronger acid or a weaker acid. Now we can see that if electron withdrawing group is present on the phenol, the electron withdrawing group, what they do, they decrease the electron density from the ring. Since the electron density is decreased from the ring, the molecule becomes, the molecule has got less charge now, and the species which has less charge is more stable. So we can say that the electron withdrawing group, since these decreases the electron density on the ring, these makes the acid stronger acid. While the electron donating groups, these increases the electron density on the ring. Because of that, the resulting acid, which is having an electron donating group on it, is a weaker acid. Here I have discussed few examples where we can easily say which one is a stronger acid and which one is a weaker acid. The first one is the nitrophenol. Nitro is an electron withdrawing group. Since it is an electron withdrawing group, it makes phenol a stronger acid. Therefore, this acid, nitrophenol, is the strongest acid among all these acids. Second is the bromophenol. Bromo halides are also electron withdrawing groups. But if we compare bromine with nitrogen with NO2, NO2 is a stronger electron withdrawing group than bromide. Therefore, bromophenol is weaker acid than nitrophenol. Next is simply phenol. Phenol comes after these two groups. After phenol is cresol. This is paracresol. It has CH3 group, and CH3 group has electron donating power. It donates. It increases the electron density on the ring as it donates the electron to the ring. Therefore, decreases the acid strength. Therefore, this cresol is weaker acid than phenol. And the last is the cyclohexanol. Cyclohexanol is an aliphatic compound. It is aliphatic alcohol. Therefore, it is weaker acid than the aromatic phenol. Next is the Williamson synthesis. In Williamson synthesis, ether is formed. On reaction with alkyl halides in alkaline medium, phenols are converted to ethers. This is aromatic ring having OH group, that is simply phenol. This is a phenol which reacts with NaOH and results in sodium phenoxide. This sodium phenoxide reacts with alkyl halide and then ether is formed. Here two molecules of sodium phenoxide reacts with alkyl halide and we obtain ether. Next is the formation of ester. Phenols on reaction with carboxylic acids, acid chlorides and acid anhydrides form ester. Here a phenol is reacted with acid chloride and here an ester is formed. The side product is HCl, an inorganic acid. In second case, phenol is reacted with acid anhydride in presence of a base like pyridine. Again, we obtain an ester which is called phenyl acetate in this case, and the side product is acetic acid. Again, a phenol is reacted with a carboxylic acid, acetic acid, in presence of a base pyridine to obtain ether, and here the side product is water. So in all these three cases we obtain esters. The difference is in the side products. Next comes the Friis rearrangement. When an ester of a phenol is heated with AlCl3, the acyl group migrates from the phenolic oxygen to the ortho or the para position on the ring, and this rearrangement is known as Friis rearrangement. This is phenyl propionate. When this is heated in presence of aluminium chloride, this acyl group CO(C2H5) this migrate to para position or to ortho position. When it migrates to para position, we obtain para hydroxy phenyl ethyl ketone, and when it migrates to ortho position, we obtain ortho hydroxy phenyl ethyl ketone. Next comes the reaction with the zinc dust. On reacting phenol with zinc dust, simply hydrocarbons are obtained. The zinc removes the oxygen from the benzene, from the phenol, and the benzene is obtained. Next is reaction with ammonia. Phenols, when reacted with ammonia at high temperature and pressure, and in presence of some catalyst like anhydrous zinc chloride, these are converted to anilines. The OH group is replaced by the NH2 group. This ammonia just reacts with OH group. Water is removed and NH2 group is attached to the benzene ring. And this compound is known as aniline. Next, we'll be discussing the reactions of the phenol which are due to the presence of benzene ring. Phenols undergo electrophilic substitution reaction. This type of reactions are because of the ortho-para direction of the OH group. As I have discussed in the resonance stabilization of the phenoxide ion, we have seen that the electron density increases on the ortho and para position. The OH group, oxygen of the OH group, it donates the electron to the ring at ortho and para position and increases the electron density there. So the incoming electrophile, what is an electrophile? Electrophile is electron loving species. So it will attach to a position which is rich in electron. The ortho and para position are rich in electron. Therefore, the incoming electrophile will be substituted at ortho or para position. The first one we will be discussing halogenation. In halogenation, this is the phenol. If it is reacted with aqueous bromine, you have to keep in mind, if it is reacted with aqueous bromine, then only we will obtain 2,4,6-tribromophenol. In another case, if phenol is reacted with bromine in presence of carbon disulfide, then we will obtain para-bromophenol plus ortho-bromophenol. The para compound and the ortho compound are obtained separately. So this has to be kept in mind. In presence of aqueous bromine, we obtain ortho para simultaneously in the same product, while in use bromine in presence of carbon disulfide, we obtain para product and ortho product as different products. Next reaction is nitration. The nitration of phenol is carried out in presence of dilute nitric acid at 290 Kelvin. If we use dilute nitric acid, we obtain para-nitrophenol and ortho-nitrophenol as two different products. But if we carry out the reaction of phenol in presence of concentrated nitric acid, we again obtain 2,4,6-trinitrophenol, and this compound is known as picric acid. One important thing about picric acid is that this is the only organic acid which does not contain any carboxyl group, because organic acids are the compound which has COOH group. But picric acid has no COOH group, but still it is called acid, and this is picric acid. The next reaction of phenol is sulfonation. This reaction also happens due to ring. At low temperature, ortho products are favored, while at high temperature, the para products are favored if we react phenol with sulfuric acid. At low temperature, that is at 288 Kelvin, if phenol is reacted with sulfuric acid, the water is eliminated and we obtain orthophenol sulfonic acid. If the same thing is reacted with sulfuric acid but at high temperature, that is at about 373 Kelvin, again the water is eliminated and we obtain paraphenol sulfonic acid. So the temperature is important thing, because that determines that which product will be obtained, ortho or para. Next is the Friedel-Crafts reaction. We have two types of Friedel-Crafts reaction, alkylation and acylation. In alkylation, we react phenol with an alkyl group, alkyl halide, RX. And the alkyl part of the alkyl halide, it gets substituted to ortho or para position. But the para product is the major product. Next is the Friedel-Crafts acylation. In Friedel-Crafts acylation, we react phenol with acid chloride or acid anhydride. The same product are obtained in both the cases, and the difference is in the side product. If we react phenol with this acid chloride, we obtained alkoxyphenol and alkoxyphenol and the side product is hydrogen chloride. But if we react phenol with anhydride, again we obtain alkoxyphenol and the side product is acid. Only the difference in the two reactions is in the side product. The next reaction of phenol is the coupling with diazonium salt. When treated with diazonium salt in weakly alkaline solution, phenols undergo coupling to form hydroxyazo compounds. This is the benzene diazonium chloride. When this is treated with phenol in weakly alkyne medium, we obtain para-hydroxybenzene, where these two benzene rings fuse from the position to which the azo chloride is present, and the phenol fuse to this ring para to the position from where OH is attached, and we obtain dyes in this case. Next comes the special reaction of phenols. In the special reaction of phenols, the first one is the Kolbe's reaction. In Kolbe's reaction, when phenol is treated with carbon dioxide under pressure, and we obtain in presence of some alkali, and we obtain sodium phenoxide. When this is reacted with carbon dioxide at high temperature and high pressure, the pressure has to be about 4 to 7 atmospheres, we obtain sodium salicylate. This sodium salicylate on hydrolysis with some weak acid like dilute HCl or dilute sulfuric acid, we obtain salicylic acid. And this salicylic acid is the starting compound for the preparation of aspirin. Next important reaction of phenol is Riemann-Thiemann reaction. In Riemann-Thiemann reaction, an aldehyde group is introduced in the phenol when the phenol is heated with chloroform and alkali. And this aldehyde group mainly enters at the ortho position. This is the phenol. It is treated with chloroform CHCl3 plus the base NaOH, and we obtain the aldehyde group, CH group, at the ortho position. This is known as salicylaldehyde. Next is the thalene reaction. In thalene reaction, phenol is treated with thalic anhydride in presence of concentrated sulfuric acid, and the phenols are converted to thalenes. Here we see we take two phenols and we react them with thalic anhydride. The para hydrogen of the phenol, in both the case we take para hydrogen, it reacts with the oxygen of the thalic anhydride in presence of concentrated sulfuric acid. Now this concentrated sulfuric acid, this removes water from these compounds, and we obtain an addition product which is known as phenolphthalein. This phenolphthalein is an important indicator in the acid-base titration. On exposure to air and light, phenol gets oxidized. Phenol turns pink on exposure to air and light due to their slow oxidation. First of all, phenols are converted to quinones. This is a phenol which, when reacts with oxygen, it is converted to quinone. This compound is known as quinone. Then these quinones combined with phenol through hydrogen bonding and forms a brilliant red addition product which is known as phenoquinone. Here we can see we have two phenol groups which reacts with the quinone, and a hydrogen bond is formed between them, and we obtain a brilliant red compound which is known as phenoquinone. Next is the Claisen rearrangement. In Claisen rearrangement, this type of rearrangement, that is the Claisen rearrangement, involves aryl and alkyl ethers. The alkyl group of the ether migrates from the ether from ether oxygen to the ring carbon at ortho position at around 475 Kelvin. But if the ortho position are occupied, that is, then this group has to go to the para position because it has no ortho position to go, so it migrates to the para position. Here we can see this is the alkyl phenyl ether. This alkyl phenyl ether, when heated at 475 Kelvin, we obtained ortho alkyl phenol. Here this allyl part, it migrates to the ortho position. But in the second case, we see that both the ortho positions are occupied, and now this allyl group has no position to go at ortho position, so it has to migrate to para position. It will not go to meta position because meta position is electron deficient. Only ortho and para positions are electron rich. Therefore, this group will go to the para position if ortho position is not vacant, and we obtain 4-allyl-2,6-dimethylphenol. So these were the important reactions of phenol. There are some basic differences between alcohols and phenols. there are some reactions which are given only by phenols and not by alcohols. The first one is the litmus paper. If take a blue litmus paper and if we dip it in alcohol solution, then there will be no effect on the litmus paper. But the same litmus paper, if we take the blue litmus paper and we dip it in the phenol solution, then the phenol will turn the blue litmus to red. This shows the acidic nature of the phenol. Alcohols are also acidic, but these are very weak acids, and phenols are better acids than alcohols. Next is reaction with ferric chloride solution. If we take ferric chloride solution and we react it with alcohol, we will find that no reaction occurs. But the same solution, ferric chloride solution, FeCl3 solution, when treated with phenol, we obtain a characteristic violet, red or green color, depending upon what type of solution we have taken, phenol solution, whether it is aqueous solution or it is alcoholic solution. So again, here also we can distinguish alcohols and phenols on treating them with ferric chloride solution. Next is reaction with sodium hydroxide. Since alcohols are weak acids, these do not react with sodium hydroxide. But phenols being better acids than alcohol, these react with sodium hydroxide. Sodium hydroxide being a base, it reacts with phenol, which is an acid, to form salt and water. That is, the phenol neutralizes the sodium hydroxide solution and forms salt and water. Again, the next distinction is with the help of bromine water. Bromine water does not react with alcohols. But if we take the bromine water and treat it with phenols, we obtain white precipitate. The next distinction is with the reaction with the diazonium chloride. If we react alcohols with diazonium chloride, we obtain no colored compound. That is, no reaction has taken place. But if we take diazonium chloride and react it with phenol, we obtain some colored compounds which are known as dye. These are due to the presence of acidic nature of phenol. So these are the points with which we can distinguish alcohols and phenols. With this, I end my lecture. Thanks to all of you.